I'll wait for another 2 minutes, then I'll start the class. Just bear with me. I'll start my class after 2 minutes. After that, I have joined in a Gautam University. So whatever the knowledge I have gained from IIT professors and also in the journey of teaching, what are the concept I have learned so far? I'll try to share with you some of the concept in today's class. Today, I'm going to explain the applications of electrostatics in day-to-day life. Why I have taken this particular topic is, there is a reason. The reason is, from last 1 week, huge rains are there. When I'm traveling towards my home, especially at 6:30, 7:30, I used to see a lot of lightning. So I had got the doubt, so why can't you explain the lightning concept to the students, how it gets generated? What is the current is passing through the lightning? Is there any possibility of storing the lightning energy? Or how to protect from the lightning? So this is the idea came into the mind. So that is the reason I have taken this particular topic, electrostatics and their applications in day-to-day life. Because you are all very good at solving the problems. Because you're training for the upcoming exams, maybe the IIT mains exam or maybe the entrance exam, you are so very good at solving the problems related to the Coulomb's law, calculation of electric field at a point due to the sphere. It may be hemisphere or solid sphere, or it may be the point charge, or maybe the conducting plate. You're very good at solving the problems, but you miss the point. The applications. You can solve any number of problems because formula related problems you're able to solve like anything, but the application point you miss. Where I want to touch that particular application level now. I'm not going to deal with any mathematics in the classes. I was to explain what is the concept and how it is applied. So this is what I'm trying to explain you in today's session. And also, yesterday, I attended 2 lectures from this Krishna Garu as well as Provisi Garu. I have seen most of the people are computer science people. And you get the doubt how the physics is related to the computer science. And some of the people are so scared about attending the physics classes to solve the physics problems. So what is that? Out of 100 people, 50 people may not like the subject physics. Most of the people like mathematics, chemistry manageable, whereas physics does not, because physics related to the understanding of the concept and applying the skills to solve the problems. So why the people got scared about physics? Because I'm trying to look at number of people from the last 10 years. Most of the people are saying that, sir, we are not understood the concept properly. There is a problem in that our system. Because from childhood days, from 8th to 10th or intermediate level, there is a one-side learning. The faculty is explaining on the board, you're writing, you're executing. It's a one way. Even though you have the doubt, you can't raise in front of the students so that faculty may reduce the marks or something. So the talent is there with you, but you never expose it to the environment. Whereas in the university level, is that teaching is completely different. It is activity-based learning. Means we are sharing the knowledge in the group members. If there are any misconcepts, that is going to be deleted from the minds of the students by in the group session. The faculty is going to explain where the student is not able to understand the concept. Then he'll demonstrate with respect to live experiment in the classroom so that the concept is going to be clear, crystal clear. So in this session, I'm trying to explain you the applications of electrostatics towards general observations. And also, the most of the people, the learning the physics subject, like early morning, you woke up at 3:30 or 4:30, mug up and put it on the paper, you got the full marks. 10 out of 10, maybe 60 out of 60. This is not the way in the university level. You have to understand and you have to solve the problem, you have to create the problem, you have to get the solution from that. If you love the physics, really, you enjoy the physics. It's like a tasting ice cream bite by bite. So the physics is nothing but an ice cream. If you start loving it, definitely you really enjoy. The physics is dealing with the understand the natural phenomenon of the universe. The physics deals with the natural phenomenon of the universe. 1 minute. So physics dealing with the natural phenomenon of the universe. The meaning of physics comes from the Greek word, the knowledge of nature. Deals with the knowledge of nature because the nature follows the physics laws. So in the particular session, I'm trying to give more number of day-to-day life examples which are connected to this particular topic, electrostatics. At the same time, in the particular period time, I'll try to show some of the live demonstration, like a plasma ball, which is observing on the screen. I'll try to demonstrate to you. At the same time, I'll use some of the interesting topics you can do at your home and try to learn the subject from that and analyze it from the previous topic which you studied in the intermediate. So coming to the topic, the first I want to discuss, this is the lecture plan of my topic. What is electrostatics? What do you mean by electrostatic force? The next point I'm trying to cover, what is the Coulomb's law and what its limitation? Because you're very good at solving the Coulomb's law problem, but you're not seeing the limitation of the Coulomb's law. This is what I'm trying to discuss. What is the causes of lightning? Just now I said that I used to see a lot of lightnings. So what is the energy? How to avoid, how to protect from the lightning ourselves? This is what I'm trying to discuss more on this. Now come to the applications. In that, first thing I'm going to explain about the Van de Graaff generator. What is the use of Van de Graaff generator? The next part is photocopier. Suppose you're absent for the today's class. A lot of notes is there. What you'll prefer? You'll prefer friend's notes. Going directly go to the Xerox shop, you're taking the photocopy of that. So the technology is enhanced now. Previously, olden days, they used to go with stylus. Now it is changed into the photocopier. The next part, defibrillator. To restart the defibrillator is a medical device which is related to the restart of the heartbeat. The next part is electrostatic spray painting. How the electrostatic is applicable for the painting mode. The next part is electrostatic speakers. You aware that the speakers are related to the magnetic, because a magnet, there is a diaphragm. Whenever the sound, the diaphragm is going to operate. So what do you mean by electrostatic speakers? It's a new word. So I'm trying to stress more on this electrostatic speakers. The next part is precipitators. I want to remove the dust particles from the air. How can I remove? So this is the one I'm trying to explain you, the electrostatic precipitators. And also I'll keep on touch on about some of the live examples like electroplating, how it is going to be worked. Now, what do you mean by electrostatics? The meaning itself indicates static means rest. The electrostatic is a branch of physics which studies about the electric charges at the rest or slowly moving charges without any acceleration. So this is the word electrostatics. Static means rest, electro means charge. So the charge which is at the rest, we're dealing with that. That is said to be the electrostatics. In the case of electrostatics, there is a force experienced by the charged one. So they're getting a force. That force is described by the Coulomb's law. The next part is, these electrostatic forces are non-contact forces because these non-contact forces are responsible for push or pull the charges without touching them. And one more important property here, it is the, in a crystal, all the atoms are bounded together with a certain force. That force is nothing but electrostatic force. So the electrostatic force is one of the strongest forces that able to close pack the atoms in the crystal lattice. This is about the electrostatics. So in the Coulomb's law, when you look at the Coulomb's law, there are two charges. One is positive charge and other one is a positive charge. We know that there is a repulsive force acting between them. So this action and reaction are in the same line. The action and reaction are in the same line. Similarly, if they are opposite charges, it get attracted with each other. So the Coulomb's law says that the force which is directly proportional to the product of the two charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Inversely proportional to the square of the distance. If ask the question, what is the Coulomb's law? If people used to said F is equal to Q1 Q2 by R square. This is not the correct, because a force is a vector quantity. Because that force is a vector quantity, we have to define magnitude and the direction. Here, the two charges are kept at certain distances. The two charges are kept at certain distances. The two charges are kept at certain distance with respect to the origin. So calculate the net displacement R12. From that, you are able to calculate the net distance from this. Force is a vector quantity. So you have the magnitude and you have the direction for that. So what is the limitation of the Coulomb's law? Coulomb's law is applicable for the point charges. The Coulomb's law is applicable to the point charges, which is at the rest position. And it is applicable where the inverse square law is valid. It is applicable where the inverse square law is valid. Now let's come to the where it is not applicable. The Coulomb's law is not applicable when the charges are like an arbitrary shape. When the charges are in the arbitrary shape, so we cannot apply the Coulomb's law like this. Suppose the charges are like this. If the charges are like this, randomly, the charges are like this, the Coulomb's law we cannot apply. So this is the one. The next important property is, it is not valid within the nucleus. The Coulomb's law is not valid within the nucleus because within the nucleus, it consists of protons and neutrons. The protons are positive charged. So due to the positive charge between the protons, there is a repulsive force is acting. So due to this phenomena, nucleus to be unstable, but which is not correct. The nuclear forces binding the protons together, so that the Coulomb's law does not applicable within the nucleus. The Coulomb's law is valid after the nucleus, maybe 10 to the power of minus 15 meters from that. So within the nucleus, the Coulomb's law is not valid. So let us go with the laws of static charge. The opposite charges attract each other. Like charges repel with each other. The charged objects attract neutral object. These are the laws of static charge. So let us come back to there are two possible currents. One is conduction current and static current. So here I'm talking about only the current produced due to the static charges. If the current is the charge flowing through a material, that's a conduction current. Here I'm talking about only the static current, which is nothing but due to the electric discharge. This electric discharge is a rapid transfer of electrical energy. The discharge which is occurring rapid, faster manner to touch the ground. It usually results when the charged object is in a grounded. When the charged object is grounded, the charge is going to be discharged so fastly. So it constitutes a current. That current I'm calling as a electrostatic current. So this is the phenomena is involved in the lightning. So let us look at what is the point of lightning. So here in the lightning, especially in the rainy season, this is the phenomenon is going to be happen. How this one? So I'm trying to explain you the concept of physics involved in this particular topic. So in the cloud, the friction between the clouds and the turbulent wind causes the charges to be developed within the cloud. So these charges, more density of the charges, positive charges moving upwards, whereas the electrons are coming the downwards. These are the electrons at the down level. These electrons trying to discharge to the opposite side. So it is finding where the path I can discharge. From the ground, it induces a positive charge. So these electrons are coming down. These electrons I'm calling as a stepper electron, means which are coming forward. These electrons are coming down from the ground. The positive charges is called upper head charges. They're moving in the upward direction. So the electrons which are coming down from the cloud, the positive charges which are moving from the ground, where they can meet, at that point the lightning is occur. So it finds the path to travel to the ground. So all the positive charges on the ground moving in the upward direction. So this is the phenomena is occurring in the lightning mode. I repeat, due to the turbulence in the cloud, due to the frictions, the more amount of charges are developed. Due to the rapid change in the temperature, positive charges moving the upward direction, electrons are coming the downward direction. These electrons are moving towards the ground. These electrons are said to be the stepper electrons, or forward electrons. And from the ground, the positive charges moving in the upward direction is called upward charges. Where they are going to meet, at that point, it finds the path for the current. So there is a flow of current, which creates a lightning spark. So this is the one occurring in the lightning. This is what I'm trying to explain here. First one is turbulent charge generated by friction. So the negative charge and positive charge, they're moving like this. So like this, you are able to that means the lightning is going to be occur. This lightning generates huge amount of the potential difference. Can you guess how much it is? Can you guess how much it is? Can you guess? The answer is around 3,000 millivolts. 3,000. And did you guess how much current? 30,000 amperes. So in the lightning, we are going to generate 30,000 amperes of current. And also the lightning, which occurs at very shorter time period, the time period recorded as of now from 30 milliseconds to the 100 milliseconds. So this is about the lightning. Now, how many types of lightning? I'm so curious about to know that how many types of lightning occurs. It may be the four. The lightning is possible by four methods. The first one is cloud to the air, because the friction between the cloud and the air causes one type of lightning. It is said to be the cloud to air. The next part is cloud to cloud. The friction between the clouds, especially the cumulonimbus clouds, whenever there is a friction, there may be they're moving forward, they causes the friction that produces the lightning spark, especially the cumulonimbus cloud to cloud. The next part is within the cloud. Whatever we're observing, it is nothing but within the cloud. The next category is the cloud to the ground, where we can see the lightning spark from cloud to the ground, from ground to the cloud. Here two types of possibility, cloud to ground, positive and negative. The positive means coming from directly from cloud to this ground. This is the positive. The other one is from this, the transfer of positive charges from the ground to the surface. Now, which is the more intense? The more intense one is this. The larger amount of the energy is produced in this particular point. Okay, I hope you understood. Let's see the, to understand more clearly about the topic, let's see the video and enjoy the topic now.
Lightning is electricity, and electricity involves tiny particles. Some particles have a positive charge, and some have a negative charge. The two opposite charges pull towards each other, like the north and south ends of magnets. Usually, electric charges are fairly balanced, but the turbulent winds of a storm cause electric charges to separate within the cloud. Most lightning occurs within the cloud itself, but we're concerned about the lightning between clouds and the ground. Lightning starts with negative charges moving from the clouds towards the ground. Scientists call it a stepped leader. Meanwhile, an upward leader forms as positive charges move up from the ground, usually from tall objects. When a stepped leader and an upward leader meet, it makes a path for a much larger and brighter electric current to shoot up into the cloud. This is what we see in the sky as lightning. It happens so quickly that lightning seems to travel from the cloud to the ground, when in fact the opposite is true.
I hope you understood the concept of lightning. So let us go with the next topic.
Lightning.
Now the question comes to you. Are you safe lightning under a tree? The question is, are you safe from lightning under a tree? Your grandfather or grandmother, your father suggested that, especially in the rainy days, lightning occurring, don't stand under the tree. They'll say this. Why? What is the reason for that? Why you're not standing near the tree or under the tree? What is the reason for that? Let us understand now. The answer is no, we can't stand. If you stand, we don't know, maybe there or not. Let's see. What is exactly happening here? The same concept once again. The cloud, there is a negative charge. This charge try to find out the closest path where it going to discharge. I repeat, this negative charge try to find the closest path where it can able to discharge. It is finding the least potential because the charge is always flow from higher potential to the lower potential. So it try to find where the least potential is going to be occur. So on the leaves, the water droplets, these water droplets can shoot some positive charge so that that electron, the cloud, that electron finds the path and hit onto the plants. That once it is occurs, it occurs in a short times, little bit time, maybe in the short span of time, then lightning hits onto this. Those who are staying here, under the tree, they're electrified, it may cause death. So this is the reason behind that we can't able to stand under the tree or near to the tree. I'll show more number of examples how to protect from this also one to by one. So first rule is we can't stand under the tree. So due to this reason. The next part, when I'm especially in the exam days, I used to go temple because they would have please give me the more marks. I pray the God. Then I observed that Vajastambha. I used to get a lot of doubts. Why this Vajastambha? Is there any scientific reason? I'm trying to explain only with respect to the scientific point of view only. So what is the reason of keeping this Vajastambha? It may be around 20 meters height, maybe 50 meters height. What is this? And is coated with a metal object. Look at this. It is coated with a metal object. And the same, when I look at the buildings also on the roof of the building, I can find a sharp metal spike. All right. So what is the reason for that? What is the purpose of lightning rod on the building? What is the purpose they're keeping this? Then I started relating, okay, this is maybe related to the lightning. So then I started browsing the net or used to refer the Resnick and Halliday book. So I have got the point, it is related to the lightning. So this is the scientific fact, why it is. I'm trying to explain you now, what is this reason? Can you guess? I'll use a little bit time. Can you guess the answer? Yes, after within the video, you got some points. So most of the people, you're trying to give the answer. Now I'll explain. Because I told that this lightning, looking at the shortest path where it wants to discharge, looking for the lowest potential. Because this metallic rod is the lowest potential. So once hits this metallic particular one, this is going to transfer to the earth directly. It is grounded. So this is the way the lightning traveling towards this, so that we got protected. So this is the reason behind a scientific reason behind this one, because it is looking the shortest path which is available. Suppose your height is greater than the tree height. Let me say the lightning directly falls onto you. You are greater than the tree height, or you are greater than, suppose you are greater than this height, Dhwajastambham, let me say, the lightning occurs. First hitting portion is yours only, because it's finding the nearest distance so that it can't be discharged. So this is the reason they're keeping greater height. And also, if you observe so carefully, these temples are outskirts of the village. They're created outskirts of the village so that any lightning occurs in that, it directly falls onto the lightning rod, it's going to transfer to the ground. So this is the way the facts around the things. So let me look at this video, how to protect from the lightning. My question is now, how to protect? So can I wear a Superman dress so that I can protect the lightning, or any Spider-Man dress, or maybe two more cloths, or maybe I can cover with insulated shirt, or I can wear any metallic enclosure. So this makes you to understand, so how to protect from the lightning. Please watch the video. I'll pass for some time, then I'll try to do the remaining. Please watch the video carefully.
If you get caught in the middle of a big open field during a lightning storm, which of the following uniforms would be most likely to keep you safe? A thick wetsuit? A Superman costume? A medieval coat of armor? Or your birthday suit? If you answered medieval coat of armor, you might be a little crazy, but you'd also be right. You'd be crazy, of course, because lightning is much more likely to strike metal than rubber, fabric, or bare skin. The reason is that lightning bolts are just long streams of fast-flowing electrons looking for the easiest path from point A to point B, and no everyday material provides an easier path than metal. So why would a material that lures lightning bolts keep you safe during a thunderstorm? Ironically, for the exact same reason it attracts the lightning in the first place. Metal is a great conductor of electricity. Electrons glide so easily over metals that they barely penetrate into the surface. And if an electrical current happens to be moving over a hollow metal container, like a can or a box or even a welded coat of armor, the current won't reach the inside of the container. Physicists call this kind of container a Faraday cage, or in the case of the steel-woven clothing worn by linemen working on high-voltage wires, a Faraday suit. In fact, your car is an everyday example of a Faraday cage, which is why, despite what you may have heard about rubber tires, it's actually the closed metal chassis surrounding you that keeps you safe. It channels lightning around rather than through you. Of course, if you're away from your car and get caught in an open field during a storm, chances are slim that you'll have a medieval coat of armor or high-voltage line suit handy. In that case, whether you're naked or in costume, your body unfortunately happens to be a better electrical conductor than both air and soil, so it provides a great shortcut for traveling current. Stand upright and you're the fastest route for a descending lightning bolt. Lie down and you're the best path for current racing along the ground from a nearby strike. So the best thing to do is crouch low and keep your feet close together. Crouching low is obvious, but similarly important, when your feet are right next to each other, your legs don't make for much of a shortcut for the current to get from A to B. And even if they are the best path for the lightning, when your feet are the only thing touching the ground, then the current will most likely travel up one leg and down the other, missing critical organs like your heart, something these cows couldn't avoid. But actually, the real best thing to do is avoid lightning altogether, and head indoors when you spot a storm on the horizon.
Yeah, you watched the video now. So you understood something. I'll summarize. So he discussed about Faraday cage. What do you mean by Faraday cage? I will explain you now. I used to get more, my parents, my grandfathers used to say me to me, whenever the lightning occurs, please lay down. Please lay down. Just now he's talking in the video, lay down. Otherwise, both your legs get to one-to-one contact and just sit like this. Why? Because even though you got affected, the major parts of the body cannot get injured, only legs get injured. The better way is just go to the, just find out the place where you can avoid the lightning. If, unless, suppose you're not in a position to this, you're an open ground, lightning occurs too much, you are protect from yourself, the best way is lay down. This is the way you can avoid the lightning with respect to this. Now I'm trying to give one more a question to you now. Please listen this. So it is safe to use cell phones in open environment during lightning. Is it safe to use cell phones in open environment during lightning? Is it safe? Please think. Most of the people we are doing this. Most of the people are doing this particular activity. Is it safe? As with respect to me or with respect to the subject, no, it's not safe. So our, we have one habit that we can't agree until there is a proof. I'm trying to show that proof now. It recently occurred in India only. One of your friend is an engineer, which is occurred in the Pune. He's moving towards the railway station with their parents, especially in the more lightning occurring in the place, huge rain. So he got a call and is answering. Suddenly what happens? The lightning strike here. The lightning strike on the person. Because the lightning doesn't have the direction. It is erratic. It's not a straight line. It is a zigzag manner. So due to this, what happens? The lightning exactly hit onto this, because I told that the lightning prefers the least potential. The metal is a least potential. So what happens? That lightning exactly strike onto this particular person, which is holding the phone. It got electrified. And he got death. The persons near to that parents, that survived because they're not using any metallic or electronic gadgets. So I'll prefer, please don't use mobile phones in the especially open environment during the rainy season. So the next point, let's see some of the facts about the lightning. What is the energy level? What is this? The first one is the amount of voltage is created. The amount of voltage which is created to 10 to 100 million volts. The amount of voltage potential difference is created is 10 to 100 million volts. Can you guess? In our householders, we are getting only 230 volts maximum, a battery, 200 volts, maybe 500, maybe 1000. It is in terms of, I'm worrying about million. Can you guess the current? 30,000 amperes. 30,000 amperes. See that. Our electronic circuits or household, we are getting maximum current 5 amperes, 12 amperes. For laboratories, it may cross 32 amperes. Whereas here it is 30,000 amperes. And can you guess the temperature? It is 30,000 degrees centigrade. In terms of foreign heat, 50,000 degree foreign heat, which is 5 times greater than the temperature produced on the surface of the sun. 5 times. See that. What is the temperature? Now one more question is, why it is giving cracking sound? Why it is giving the cracking sound? Because due to the temperature, the increase in pressure, the air expands suddenly. It's an adiabatic process. The air expands suddenly, which causes the sound. Did you observe the frequency, the speed of that? It is above the speed of the sound, 360 meters per second. It may be greater than that. which are set with the shock wave. It is a more than the speed of sound, 360 meter per second. This is the one. And can you guess what is the time period so that I can escape from the lightning? It is in terms of milliseconds, 30 milliseconds to the 100 milliseconds, so that we cannot escape from the lightning. Only the way to protect ourselves is either lay down or go to the room. Better thing is go for Faraday cage. Let me see now. Now, what happens when the lightning strikes an airplane? What happens when lightning strikes an airplane? Is it passengers get injured? The same case when you're traveling in a car, the lightning hits on the car, or you get injured. Just know if you have seen the video. No, because it is related to the Faraday cage. It is related to the concept of Faraday cage. So what happened to in this case? What happens to in this case? It is also a Faraday cage. It is also Faraday cage. And one more thing, please observe the flights carefully. Almost most of the people are travel. Look at the wings. Look at these particular places. You can see, suppose this is the wing. Let me say this is the wing of the flight. You can see like these spikes. What is this? What is the use of this? I'll show that also. Like spikes, like this sharp thing. What is the reason of sharp needle objects? What is the reason for that? Let me understand now. And also, when the flight is moving away from the runway, lightning strikes, the pilot knows about the weather atmosphere in the radar, so that he will try to change the direction, maybe lower the height or above the height, because the clouds above the maybe 1 kilometer from the ground, it may be the flight moving the upward and upward directions so that you can avoid. But just the flight tick off from the runway hits. So is it passengers are injured? As per the concept, as per the no things, it's no. Why? Because let's see related to the Faraday cage. Just look at this video.
Along the plane's metal skin, but doesn't get inside or damage any important parts. Now that planes are covered not with pure aluminum, but with composite materials, they get a special layer of a conductive mesh made from copper foil. The mesh looks like an electrically conductive canvas covering the plane's skin. In short, the aircraft becomes one giant Faraday cage. That's a special mechanism that English physicist and inventor Michael Faraday created way back in 1836 to protect devices from electromagnetic radiation. The cage is still used for the same purpose and works quite simply. When an outer electromagnetic field acts upon the cage, free electrons in its metal start moving. That charge gets redistributed around the cage's exterior and cancels any radiation that tries to get to the interior. But protecting airplanes from lightning doesn't end with the exterior materials. The internal systems and cables are also covered with copper meshes. The fuel tanks get filled with a neutral gas so that they don't catch on fire. And finally, to lower the chances of coming into a lightning bolt's path, there are special static eliminators installed at the wing's edges. Static discharge flows off of them and out into the air. Thanks to that, the plane always stays neutrally charged and doesn't attract lightning in the first place.
Yeah, this is the reason behind the keeping the lightning protectors. So which, like this, these are the sharp objects where the charge is going to be leaked from this. So I'm discussing about the Faraday cage. Simple example, I'll try to explain you. Do this experiment at your place. Take two mobile phones, okay? Take one of your brother or sister mobile phone, take a plastic beaker, plastic container, insert and close it and try to make a call. So you observe the phone is ringing, right? That means electromagnetic wave is transferring through the material. The first observation. The second thing is, I'll take a tiffin box, I'll insert my mobile into the tiffin box, metal box. I'm closing now. Then do the same process, try to call. So what your observation? The observation is the phone is out of coverage area or blank sound. Why? It is related to the Faraday cage, because from this concept we are understanding that the electromagnetic waves are reflected from the metal surface. The electromagnetic waves are reflected from the metal surface. Now let us relate with respect to our intermediate concept. We know that for a conductors, the charge appears only on the surface. Even though if at all you want to keep any charge in the surface, the charge distribution occurs in a such a manner that the electric field inside the conductor is zero. The same concept is a Faraday cage. Here I'm trying to show the animation. So these are the field lines. Look at this, there is no field. Electromagnetic waves are, electric field is moving like this. The charge distribution is occurring with the metal frame. It cancels, no electric field is inside. This is said to be the Faraday cage. I hope you understood the concept. I repeat, the charge resides only on the surface of the conductor. Even though you want to keep any charge on the conductor, it neutralizes itself. So there is no field within the conductor. This is said to be the Faraday cage. Like the electromagnetic waves get reflected. The same concept involved in that, why the electromagnetic waves get reflected from the ionosphere. It is also the same thing. It reflected from the charged ones. I'll talk more about this plasma and this one in the next upcoming lecture. Now, without knowing this, we're using all this. Suppose when you purchase any, the PC, or when you purchase any RAM or maybe any electronic component, they will give in a pouch. They will give in a pouch. We feel that it's a plastic cover. No, it's not a plastic cover. It is coated with some metal item, metal powder, so that a silver foil like this, it acts like a Faraday cage. Because the static charges in the atmosphere may damage the functioning of the electronic device. So this is the one, it is a Faraday cage. The next part, if you purchase any laptop or mobile phone or any electronic goods, we are making a bag. That bag is also a Faraday cage, because the static charges may affect the functioning of the semiconductor devices. Or if you look at the PCB boards, look at the PCB board, there is also a metallic box. Why is it? Just now we have done that. So it acts like a Faraday cage. No charges, static charges may affect the functioning of the semiconductor devices. So this is about the Faraday cage. I hope you understood the concept of Faraday cage. Let's see, this is a video I've taken from the MIT web content. I'll try to demonstrate this experiment in my classroom. Once you come physically come to the campus, I'll do this experiment in front of you so that really you enjoy the subject, but it requires a lot of care. So let's see, this is a Tesla coil. It is a Tesla coil. I'll show you in the next class. This is a Tesla coil, which you can generate the electric spark due to the induction. We are generating the electric spark, artificial spark in the classroom or in the environment due to the induction. You might have seen the movie, Telugu recent movie Detector, where the hero is going to do this experiment to demonstrate. He's killed one of the targeted person because the fellow is, they have the habit to call at evening times on the surface of the, in the floor, on the top floor. So he targeted using this. He created that as a death because of lightning. Because he's a detective, so he tried to analyze how the lightning occurs only at that place, especially that particular person. So there's a lot of stories there. So this is related to the concept, the creation of electric spark artificially. So here one of the professor, which is moving into the Faraday cage, metallic enclosure. Then he sits in that, he's passing the lightning spark. So what is going to be happen? Let's see and enjoy. Please don't try it at home. So I hope you enjoyed the video. So this is related to the Faraday cage. Now you got the all the fundamental principles are clear. You know what in the Faraday cage and all the parameters. Now my question comes to you. The next application is Van de Graaff generator. So we completed the concept lightning and all those things. I'm trying to pose one question to you. Please listen carefully and try to give the answer. It may be the chart mode or later. You have seen the lightning. Is it lightning striking at the same place twice? I repeat the question. Is it the lightning strikes the same place at same different time periods? Striking it at the twice mode? Yes. Suppose let me say this place the lightning got strike maybe after 1 hour back. Is it lightning may not occur at the same place once again? Please think that. So as per the report browsed from the last 10 days, I got the report that one place the lightning repeated 52 times in the US. The lightning is repeated 52 times at the same place from last 3 months. So this is the way you understood that. So don't feel that lightning cannot occur once again in the same place. Okay, it depends upon the conditions. Now, here I'm trying to explain you the Van de Graaff generator. Before going to this, I want to demonstrate what do you mean by plasma bulb now. Can you switch off the light? So this is the plasma bulb where the charge is going to be occur here. Now, when I'm keeping my hand, you can see that the charge is going to be leaked from my hand. You can see that it is finding the path to move toward down. So like this, the same process is occurring in the lightning. I repeat, it is finding the path when I'm touching with my hand, this is my least potential, is trying to go from this. When you come to the class, I'll explain you what is the working mechanism of plasma. The plasma is the fourth state of matter. Everything is ionized state. So like this, it is going to be, it finds the direction, it passing my hand. Suppose if you keep in any metal object, it is also is finding the path, because it finds the path to travel from the center point to this particular point. This is said to be the plasma. When you come to the campus, I'll try to explain you more carefully about this plasma. Even though you can touch, nothing is going to be happening. Now, the next point is the Van de Graaff generator. So the Van de Graaff generator is an electrostatic generator. It is an electrostatic generator. So it is there in our laboratory. So once you come to the campus, I'll demonstrate this. Let me try some of the funny experiments with the Van de Graaff generator. So this is the Van de Graaff generator. It is connected with a rubber belt, which is connected to the sharp knife, which refreshes the charges every time. The rubber belt runs in the clockwise direction. The charges from the rubber belt, which is going to be accumulate on the top surface of the dome. Charge accumulated on the top surface of the dome like this. The rubber belts runs like this. These charges, the positive charges going to be appear and deposit on the top surface. This process continues. If you run for 1 hour, you'll get lot of potential difference which is developed from top surface to the ground. So the charge get multiplied, you're getting the highest DC voltage. So it is an electrostatic generator which is used to produce the high amount of the charges. Can you guess how much amount of the voltage you are getting? We can create 5 megavolts. Creating 5 megavolts, the tabletop, whatever we are having in the laboratory, this much. In our laboratory, I didn't measure properly how much voltage is getting. At least I can sense it. How can I sense? Look at this animation. This girl is touching the Van de Graaff generator. When is holding this, touching that part, look at this, observe carefully. Look at the hair. Look at her hair. What is going to be happening here? Why we are getting spikes like this? When touching the Van de Graaff generator, here the concept lies. The concept here it is, the charge always wants to leak from the sharp edges. I repeat, the charge always wants to leak from the sharp edges. Due to that, our hair, the charge leak from the edges. So like this, this is the process going to be happen. Okay, now let us look at one more. I have created a spark in the classroom. I'll show you that. So this is the one. Look at this point. This is the experiment I have done in the classroom. So I run only for 5 minutes. All the charges appeared on the dome surface. This is a smaller dome which is having the negative. Like lightning, the charge is appearing here. Look at this. Observe carefully here. You're getting the spark. Right. The next point is, look at this. The spikes, like spikes. When you touch it carefully, really, I don't have that much hair. At least I can see someone is just a lot of hair like this. It comes like this. Right. This is related to the static electricity. If you find this type of images in any Rezik and Halde book or University Zeman's book. So this is the way the static electricity leaks from the sharp edges. One point here you have to note down. Point number one, the charge always leaks from the sharp edges. When you look at your microwave oven or deep freezer, there is a one sticker. That sticker that notes that don't insert any sharp metal objects. It creates short circuit. You observe, this is the reason. The charge always leaks from the sharp edges. So this is what about the Van de Graaff generator. The next part is photocopier. So this is invented by the US physicist Colson in the year 1930. See, look at every invention, there is a one life. If you look at any history, every invention, our Xerox machine or laser printer or anything, a blue LED or maybe the superconducting train or a bulb, Thomas Alva Edison, every invention, there's a backbone, one life. So that is the reason, try to do more application oriented, maybe in the history in the future. So this is about the process. Look at this animation. This animation explains you the applications, how the electrostatic principle is used. Please understand the point, first one. What I'm doing in the Xerox machine, I'll insert the paper, particular place. Then the light get reflected from this. The light get reflected from the image. That reflected light falls onto the toner. This is made with the selenium oxide, selenium coated. The reflected light, the image of the reflected light falls onto the selenium rotation drum. where the negative charged particles of the toner particles stick onto this. Right? That means it forms the image on the drum. It forms the image on the drum. The next part is the image is formed on the rotating drum. Now take white paper, which is having the positive charge. Look at this. The image is formed here. Now it is a negative charge. Now I'm inserting the paper. Paper, I'm giving the positive charge. When you observe the Xerox paper, once it comes from this, it is having some temperature. The file, you feel heat. Why? Because this, the negative charged particles are attracted to the paper. Paper is a positive charge and is compressed with the heat. So it is stick onto the paper. So this is about the working of photocopier. The more details about the photocopier, the laser printer, will explain by the next colleague, Dr. Rajita, by next class about the more clarity about the working of this photography. The concept is very simple. It is electrostatics. The light get reflected, that image formed on the rotating drum, negative charged particles stick onto the drum here. So this negative charged particle to be transferred to the paper, we're giving a positive charge. So this is the process is going to be occur in the case of phonography or xerography. This is said to be the photocopier. The next part is defibrillator. So this is the major part I'm focusing about, this defibrillator. The defibrillator is a medical device which is used when the person got cardiac arrest. You might have seen the movie Shivaji, right? In the Rajinikanth, so the villain named Raghuvaran is a doctor in the movie. So he's going to operate the high electric shock. He came back. He regains his natural heartbeat. It is nothing but defibrillator. A defibrillator is nothing but giving high energy shock to the patient chest, so the heart regains its the natural rhythm. This is said to be the defibrillator. So in the defibrillator, the amount of voltage we are giving 200 to 1000 volts in a shorter period of time. We are giving 200 to 1000 volts in a shorter period of time so that it regains its the natural heartbeat. So in the case of cardiac arrest, the first priority is CPR. The first priority is the CPR. The priority first one is CPR. What do you mean by CPR? The CPR stands for cardiopulmonary resuscitation. The cardiopulmonary resuscitation means first we are going for press on the chest with a certain force. If it does not regain its heartbeat, so we are giving a shock. Let me watch this video for the clear understanding of the concept.
This is a defibrillator. It can save someone's life, but only if you use it. A defibrillator is an easy to use device. You don't need any training to use it because it will tell you exactly what to do.
Shock advised.
Its job is to shock someone's heart back into a normal rhythm during cardiac arrest. However, it will only instruct you to deliver a shock if this is needed.
I hope you enjoyed the concept. The defibrillator may be two types. One is we can keep inside, that means we're keeping on the chest, that is set to the pacemaker. The next part is outside, that is now the outside defibrillator. This type of devices you may find in the railway stations or airports. Whenever the person suddenly cardiac arrest, they're going to operate by using this particular defibrillator devices. So the next part I'm going to discuss about this. What do you mean by electrostatic spray painting? What do you mean by electrostatic spray painting? Here I want to demonstrate a small experiment to you. So I have taken one balloon. So I've taken the balloon. Just I'm rubbing here. So a small experiment which used to do in the sixth class and seventh class, right? So like this, I'm doing. I'm rubbing with the silk. This is concept related. That's the reason I'm doing this experiment. When you stick onto this, it's sticking together. Right? It is sticking together. Why it is? Because when you start rubbing this, the charges are induced, negative charges on the balloon. Now, when I'm sticking to this, this particular, there is a positive charges, static charges. Due to that, it stuck together. The same concept involved in the electrostatic spray painting here. The same concept is involved in the electrostatic spray painting. 1 minute. So in the case of electrostatic spray painting, the spraying, it consists of this, we are giving the negative charge. That negative charge is going to be accumulated on the opposite electrode, which is going to be the positive charge. So the electric field lines are developed from the nozzle of the spray to the electrode, respect to opposite electrode. The spray particle is going to accumulate on the opposite coated. So what is the difference between the manual and this particular electrostatic spray? Now, here the point here it is. In the case of manual, you may not get the proper thickness, whereas here you'll get the proper uniformly thickness using the electrostatic spray painting. So try to use, just watch the video about the electrostatic. This is what I'm trying to say. The negative charge particle we're giving, this is the paint which is coming from the nozzle, the compressed air. I'm giving some negative voltage here. I'm with the negative voltage, which is coming from this. It forms an electric field lines. It forms an electric field lines. So within the region, this is electric field lines. These charged particle are going to be coated on the particular opposite electrode. So let us watch the video for the more understanding of the concept.
What is electrostatic spraying? BioPlanet's product is added to water, then combined with high-pressure air as it travels through the spray gun nozzle. The spray is atomized as the droplets pass an electrode inside of the nozzle head. Electrons are induced onto the droplets as they leave the nozzle with a highly negative charge. The negatively charged droplets are carried by a stream of air following the electrical field of force lines towards the target without losing their charge. The closer the charged droplets get to the target, the stronger the electrostatic force of attraction. The droplets have a force of attraction 75 times that of gravity, allowing them to reverse direction, move upwards against gravity, and wrap around the target, coating all hidden surface areas and providing complete and total coverage. Within minutes, the fine spray dries, and the BioPlanet protective product bonds to the surface area, ready to destroy deadly and harmful organisms.
So we understood the concept. What is the use of electrostatic spray, where you can run the painting in a proper way? The same concept, we use it for the pesticides also. Suppose a farmer wants to spread a pesticide on the leaves of the planet. So he using the same concept of electrostatic pesticides. Here, this is the spray gun. We're giving some battery, which is connected to the negative voltage, so that is going to spray. So we can see the difference between the conventional and electrostatics. In the case of conventional, the pesticide is not properly uniformly distributed, whereas in the case of electrostatics, it is properly distributed. So this is the advantages. We know that we studied the concept, but we have not seen proper application. This shows the practical applications of electrostatics in day-to-day life. So let us go with the one more. This electrostatics, we are using the spray gun, we are using for disinfection purpose. The same concept is the same. Here, in the place of pesticide, I'm using sanitizer. Suppose I want to clean certain sensitive areas, maybe the classrooms, maybe the research labs, maybe the in the flight cabin or maybe some other places, R&D labs, especially in the hospitals. I want to free from the virus, especially in our the corona pandemic situations. Everyone want sanitation of the rooms. How it can be done? Like just spraying the sanitizer like this? No, we have to follow certain procedure. That is nothing but we have to use once again the electrostatic, the spray mechanism for this. Let us watch the video for that.
The idea is simple. Static electricity creates the attraction much like this balloon, only it's a life-saving disinfectant instead of your cat. Using bleach wipes or simply power washing is simply not enough these days. Electrostatic disinfectant is quickly becoming the preferred method to ensure safety. United Airlines is using it to reach all the small nooks and crannies that are normally hard to reach. San Francisco Muni and AC Transit bus lines are also using it.
I hope you understood the concept. So another 5 more minutes. So 11:05. Please, I need another 10 more minutes. Please give me the permission. So I'll complete within 10 minutes. I don't want to waste your time. I'll wind up. The next part is, I'm talking about the electrostatic loudspeaker. So this is new to me. And also in last 10 days, I'm keep on searching about electrostatic loudspeaker. Even though I studied, but I didn't put more focus on that. So what is the advantages of electrostatic speaker compared to the magnetic speakers? In the case of electrostatic loudspeakers, we are using a membrane, is a metallic membrane, which is going to be push or pull with respect to the opposite electrodes. I repeat, look at this animation, positive and negative charges. We are giving huge, the DC voltage, the greater DC voltage between these two electrodes, so that the diaphragm starts vibrating from one end to other end. So due to the vibration, it creates the sound. This is the phenomenon of electrostatic loudspeakers. Whereas in the case of magnetic loudspeakers, there is a change of EMF that producing the vibration of the diaphragm. Right, what is the clarity about this? So using the electrostatic loudspeakers, you are getting crystal clear, proper sound. And sensitivity is so high for the electrostatic loudspeaker. One more thing is, they are transparent speakers. They are the transparent speakers. They're transparent. The thickness is going to be only maximum 2 mm thickness for this. Is it transparent? The maximum thickness is 2 mm. And compared to the cost, this cost is so high. The cost of this electrostatic speakers is so high. Suppose the ordinary loudspeaker comes in 100 rupees. It comes under maybe 1500, maybe 2000. So this type of speaker, especially designed for particular cinema halls, it gives more clarity of the sound and cost expense is more. That is the reason we are preferring for the magnetic loudspeakers, and the mechanism is quite different. So this is the video explains the working of electrostatic speakers. Please watch the video.
Available electrostatic loudspeaker. In this video, we will explain and demonstrate how an electrostatic loudspeaker works. In another video, we explain and demonstrate a conventional loudspeaker. The principle of an electrostatic loudspeaker is fundamentally different. The basic idea of an electrostatic loudspeaker is shown in this diagram. A large, thin, flexible membrane or diaphragm lies between two rigid metal plates that are perforated. The diaphragm is covered with a very thin layer of metal. Even then, it is transparent, as you can see. The diaphragm and plates are oppositely charged with a constant voltage. The total charge is zero. Each plate attracts the diaphragm with an equal but oppositely directed force. The total force on the diaphragm is then zero, so it is unflexed. But this changes when an audio signal is connected across the plates. One plate, let's say plate A, momentarily has a greater negative charge, while plate B momentarily has a less negative charge. So, compared to equilibrium, the diaphragm is more attracted to A and less attracted to B. The effect is that there is a push-pull action, which flexes the diaphragm away from plate B and toward plate A with twice the force of a single plate. When the audio signal changes sign, the diaphragm flexes in the opposite direction. The resultant oscillatory motion generates sound, and we have a loudspeaker. Electrostatic loudspeakers are essentially the reverse of capacitive microphones, which are very common. Incoming sound causes a fully available.
So you enjoyed this video. You came to know about what is the use of this electrostatic loudspeakers. Now the question for you, what are the difference between the electrostatic speakers and conventional speakers? You have seen the video, try to write the answer and submit in the assignment mode, which is circulated to you in the chat box. The next part is, I want to finish within 5 minutes. What is the use of electrostatic precipitator? I want to explain you. Suppose in the industry, the lot of pollutants which are mixing with the air atmosphere, I want to protect. Especially the pollutants, maybe the carbon, maybe certain harmful gases, I want to remove it from the industry point of view. So what they're using, they're using a precipitator mechanism. This precipitator mechanism involves, this is the mechanism. We are taking the plates, the separation distance between the plates, maybe 18 centimeters, maybe the 25 centimeters, and we're giving the huge voltage. So when the air is passing through these particular plates, the air gets ionized, they get dispersed in the positive charges and negative charges. These charges stick on to the respective electrodes. So finally, you're getting the neutral particles outside. So this is the process is involved in the case of electrostatic precipitating process. I repeat, a gas which is passing through the particular plates, which are charged, they're applying high DC voltage. So these charged particles get ionized, liberates into the two charges, positive and negative charges. They're going to attract with respect to the respective electrodes so that can be removed. So the output is non-pollutants. So this is the working principle of electrostatic precipitators. So this is what I explained to you. And I'll share the PPT files to you also for a better thing. The concept is you understood very well. Now the next part is electrostatic dusters. So this is what I'm trying to use on the board. I want to show directly. Suppose I'm writing on this. I'm using duster. What way I'm using the duster? I'm using the mechanism of hand, electrostatic. Simple concept. Using once again the technology, I'm using the same concept, the electrostatic duster. So when I'm rubbing like this, I'll demonstrate once again. Something I'm writing, I'm rubbing with my hand now. This is a charged one. So this is the direct applications of electrostatic duster. So in the market, you used to get this particular duster, which is nothing but a charged one. The feather is charged one. So this is going to attract the opposite charges. So this is the mechanism of electrostatic duster. Now one more point I want to explain here. Especially you're putting larger amount of the cloth in a washing machine, right? So what happened? The friction between the cloths creates a static clinch. It's called static clinch. That means these cloths are going to stick together. Suppose you want to remove it, you have to apply larger force. Sometimes the cloth may get tear off. So how to protect this? His reason is simple example. You've seen that. What is the use of the conditioner in that? You're using something right in that, like a softener solution, something. That is mechanism is to avoid the static clinch. The principle is to avoid the static clinch so that it makes the smoothness so that no cloths are going to attract with each other. If it attract, look at this image, a socks onto the shirt, how to remove it? There are three mechanisms. The first one is you have to use the spray, which is hygroscopic, humidity attracting substances. is a costly. Simple example is, take a metal frame, take the metal frame, just run onto this, run onto this. The charges get attracted, transferred, so that its static clinging is avoided. Otherwise, if you don't find the metal, take a paper, rub it like this. The charges get induced. So this is the use of the static clinch. So these are the points we covered. The first point is what we discussed. What is the Coulomb's law? What is the limitation? What is the cost of lightning? How to protect? And we have seen the number of applications of electrostatics principles in various fields. Maybe medicine, maybe the industry, maybe the application point of view. All the applications we have seen. And some more applications are there. Once you come to the campus physically, I'll demonstrate live in the classroom so that you can understand the concept very well. So these are the references, books I use, Szymanski, Electrodynamics by Griffiths. One of the students is asking that, sir, can I purchase the books? Please don't purchase any books at the moment. We have the soft copies. I'll share the soft copies to you so that we can go through that. Don't buy any textbooks. Already our university is having lakhs of books respect to that. So you can try to use the PDF copies or library. So I'm acknowledgement to the IIT Madras, because what are the subject I have gained from my respective professors. And I use some of the videos with the permission of YouTube, Wikipedia, and MIT web course. So after this, I'm not creating any pain on you, just stress relief. Just look at the quiz, click this link already shared in the chat box, fill your form and try to attend. It's not like giving a test. I want to test how what level you understand, because the teacher feels happy when the student get understand. That is the reason I kept the quiz in that. Teacher feels the satisfaction when you keep, sir, today understood the concept properly. This is what the teacher requires, not a money on this. The teacher feels happy when the student understand the subject. So this is the quiz. Please note down, which is posted in the chat box. Try to put it. And also, I put an assignment. This assignment is a thought provoking. It's a thought provoking, right? What is this? Why can't this? And try to give the answer in a shorter manner. Limit to 150 words. So if you have any doubts related to this, please go to the YouTube channel, type my name, T. Vishwam. You'll get a lot of videos, how things works. And I already provided the PDF copies to you so that you can go through that. Still, you're having the doubt, please drop a mail to my email ID. I'll give the email ID now. Please drop a mail. So this is the one, especially when I see the Telugu movie. So they got a spark is generated. So hero, heroine like this. From that, you got the point. So if you touch the person, are you feeling any shock by touch? So this is the article which is published in the Times of India. Please go through once. This creative is so interest fun. Please look at this. Okay. So maybe he has seen this article, may put it in the movie. Like spark produced between the two hands. Okay. So please log into my name and this. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed the lecture of electrostatics and the applications. You spend 1 hour time, at least it may be useful for your career development. And also the upcoming lectures of physics related to the how things works, maybe the electromagnetic induction stuff, how microwave works, how MRA works. Tomorrow we have the lecture on how the battery is working. Next, how this the laser printer or this inkjet printer is going to work. We have a lot of sessions, the 20 sessions are there. This especially target about what is the application of physics into the reality. Like how MRA works, how superconducting train works, how to take the thermal imaging of the camera. And all those things comes into the next subsequent classes. Please don't miss a lecture and keep more focus. Thank you and enjoy the physics. Thank you.